Welcome back to our Proactive Studios. I'm Natalie Stoberman, joined by the Chairman and CEO of GreenBank Capital, Terry Pullen. Terry, thank you for joining me. We want to talk more about GreenBank Capital and how the company specializes in mining and minerals.
Yes, that's certainly one of the sectors that we've got investments in, along with businesses in fintech, along with property, real estate, and capital markets. So we're widespread, and we offer our shareholders the ability to spread their risk when they invest with GreenBank, and we're very excited about the future. But yeah, we've had some great news recently in the mining and minerals sector. So keen to sort of talk to you about that today if we can.
Yes, let's zero in there on that release that just came out. GreenBank Capital increased its shareholding at Ubique Minerals, which is basically a Namibian lead and zinc mine. How was that significant to the company?
Yeah, it's particularly significant because Ubique is a company that was within the GreenBank portfolio for a number of years. And we got introduced to Vili Fruhomason. I'm not going to do the Icelandic name with best justice, but Vili, as we know him affectionately, and he's taken the business and reshaped and shaken it, and he's acquired an incredible opportunity in Namibia, and we have been very lucky enough to be invited to support the most recent project in Namibia, and therefore that's what we've done. But we're also fortunate enough that when we did the original deal with Vili and his team, we was able to secure the deal with some warrants. So alongside the press release that explains the new position we've had in the private placements, we also have in our own portfolio 4 million warrants at 7.5 cents, along with the recent private placement at 15 cents. So we're well positioned, and we're keen to support Vili and his team.
And how does this new position with Ubique set up what's to come for 2023?
Well, it adds to the sort of the excitement with the mining and minerals, the investments that we have. Just recently, St George's, which are also listed on the CSE market, their stock price has raised 44% over the most recent time, which is again in that mining sector. And Frank, their CEO, again is a cavalier character, a fantastic track record. And again, we're very pleased to be able to sort of be a part of that growth with the shares increasing over this period of time. So again, that's positive in that particular area, along with True Precious Metals and Queensland Gold. So we do have stakes in that overall mining and minerals area that are doing well, which is good. Alongside the mining and minerals, we have many existing businesses in fintech, in the metaverse gaming, along with our property businesses that really we believe have set us up incredibly well for 2023, when we are sure there's going to be a bounce back, and we're going to pioneer that bounce back in terms of the overall sort of markets which have been pretty depressed this year. So yeah, we're very positive about 2023, and therefore we're looking forward to it.
Thank you so much for sharing this update with us, Terry.
Thank you, Natalie.